share three brief stories of life. The first one is a little baby boy named Matthew. Matthew is an Iraqi Christian child who, when he was born, fell into my wife's hands in a hospital in Brattleboro, Vermont. Matthew's parents fled as refugees from Iraq, but they didn't get refugee status. Instead, they came to the United States on a travel visa, hoping desperately they would be able to find safety and security and a life and a future in Vermont. But when they were here, they didn't have medical care. So some people in that community contributed funds to be able to support prenatal care. My wife is a doula, a birth assistant. She works with midwives. And to be able to see that in life and hold that new baby and hear the dreams of our friends in Iran and Asil for the future of their country and the future of their people and the future of their family has given me hope. It's given me hope not that things will just get better on their own, but hope that as we share these stories, as we share our lives, as we share a relationship, that we can become captives of that same love that keeps me from being able to turn away from this world. And again, my prayer for us is that we can all become captives of that love, out of the captivity of death and into the captivity of love. The Iraqi Arabic word for midwife is walida. Walida. And I think it's not a coincidence that it's the same word used for electrical generator. Something that brings forth something that is essential, that generates, that brings out what we so desperately need, new hope, new life. And in the hospitals of Iraq, those generators make that difference. Those generators, they can keep people with the kind of support they need, they can keep food refrigerated, they can help in so many different ways. And in so many parts of Iraq, still after all this time, the electricity isn't there. I went with a friend of mine who's a civil engineer. He works to help with the generation of electricity in Iraq. I went to visit a boy on the day of his baptism. His name was Shifna. Shifna means a sheaf of wheat. And this boy is coming into a world that is uncertain at best. With this same family, I went to Easter services. And in the midst of all of those people had suffered, in the midst of the death that was surrounding them on all sides, they brought their babies to be blessed. They shared their hopes and their stories for the future. And I couldn't understand it. I couldn't understand why these people, even with my faith, even with my experience in the presence of God, I couldn't understand in all that darkness how these people could still have hope, how they could still be celebrating Easter. And then I realized that they understood it far better than I did. That it wasn't that the message of liberation and life, it wasn't that that was important because we have hope. It's that that is important because we have no hope. Because we can stand and look at the size of the military budget. Because we can look at the size of the sins that have been committed in our name. Because we need to be reminded that there is that life that triumphs. In Kaldani, which is the language of the Chaldean Christians, the language of Babylon, the language that these people still speak, the call and response on Easter is Bum Limana, which means the Lord is risen. And the response from the people is Shuha Ele. It means the Holy Spirit upon you. I want to invite you to share with me in that for a moment. So you Lord's risen response is Shuha Ele, the Holy Spirit upon him. Om Namah.
Shuha Ele.
The Lord is risen. Life against time.